love those type of songs that makes you feel some type of way, like emotional.
Säg till spriten att jag saknar det. Säg till bäcknen komma hem till mig. Säg till mitt ex att jag saknar Buzz. Säg till prästen att jag åkte fast. Säg till Stockholm inget rädda mig. Säg till din son och passa sig. Säg till din dotter och skydda sig. Och säg till folket och hylla mig. Säg till pengar och regna ner. Säg till sommaren att den är sen. Säg till Beyoncé jag vill ha henne.
It's uncompromising and it's really direct. It soothes your soul. Oh, everything. I mean, I focus a lot on sound. It's very important to me that it's the, like, the sounds I use, I choose, it's a specific. Like, it's some specific sound. I would say my producer Nish, like, we sit and we talk about sounds. He just doesn't, it's not that I come to the studio, he plays a track, yo, listen to this. It's not like that at all. We listen to sounds and then we put the sounds together into and make it a track. I like the new Travis Scott song, Antidote. I really like that because I think it's that one is minimalistic. My sounds are also like they're very minimalistic. Precious, the Depeche Mode song is since I love Kent and Yuki Bari, it's in that sound spectra. I love those type of songs that makes you feel some type of way, like emotional. And then Kanye West's My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy is just, like, it's so well produced. The productions are so cool. They're both minimalistic, but very explosive as well.
Tända alla ljusen för det är så mörkt. Be dem skina på mig genom.
For me it was that I didn't think that, like, now everything can be put on a track. I didn't realize that in the beginning. Like, you can put, you know, you can go outside and catch sounds. So that's my biggest, like, a realization. In hip-hop culture in Sweden, people don't, like, there's a very, they have a lot of, a big ego, so they don't collaborate. So I think if more people collaborated, like producers, songwriters, whatever, collaborate, that would make, you know, that would really increase the level of music. Like, it would sound much better. Roskilde. I've never been to Roskilde, but, you know, like, I've always wanted to play there. Since I was a kid, I thought it was gonna be, like, 10 people. I came out, I was really nervous. The biggest crowd I've ever seen, so that was cool.
Inget kvar, pussy, power, pengar, svär på allt jag ska ha, allt en dag.
It was awesome. It's, I don't, you know, when I'm on stage, I hear my music, it's like I don't really concentrate on the beat because I listen, you know, concentrate on my rap. And it's really awesome to hear it, like, to actually hear it again, you know, in good speakers, yeah.
Motherfucker. So you're here with me, please.